So here we go. We're live. Give a little introduction first. I'm quamonfowler for those that are new. If you are here on Facebook, thank you for catching me live. This is called an In the Shed session. And this is where I practice and kind of share my practice with the world. And so I'm on tenor. That's my main axe. And what I have pulled up on YouTube is Learn Jazz Standards, and I found Remember. So it has the changes already in there. But I'm going to pull up another tab so I can get this melody. And I'll learn this melody. And this is not my music. This is Hank Mobley. And I've been hearing it for years, over the years, and I really I didn't know the name of it until my man LaRoy turned me on to it, where he wanted me to play over it. So we're here, and I'm going to do that. I'm going to show you how I learn tunes, my process. All right. So now we got YouTube, so we can YouTube everything and learn. Gonna give me like a copyright strike, but this is okay. This is educational.
At Aspen Dental, today is the day to take back your smile. Why wait? Save 20% on your treatment.
All right, here's the tune. Here's what I'm thinking. The melody is the same on the A sections. It's the same on the A sections. So I'm going to learn that melody, and I'm going to tell you how I'm thinking about it. No sheet music, no changes or anything like that. I don't have anything. All right, y'all say it's sounding great. Yeah, bro. All right, thank you, George. Welcome to the stream. Welcome to the stream. Chelsea, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. I can see you there on YouTube. So I get the messages pop up here on the screen on YouTube. If you want to check me out on YouTube, that'd be good, because sometimes I miss the ones that come on Facebook. And so yeah, but thank y'all for y'all support and watching. So let's get it. So all right, I done did all that talking and I kind of lost sight of the melody. I want to tell you how I was thinking about it. Okay, here's the melody. Okay, so check this out. I'm thinking about the direction of this. Going back up, down, down, then up. One more time. Okay. That's a zigzag. So beedle, beedle, beep. Let's double check. I can hear myself come through those headphones. Here we go. Let's double check. Okay. That's it. I got it. That's it. And now I play that. That's right. And then I think. Okay, that's it. Okay. Okay. Let me try that again. Okay, so I gotta go back up to hit that D. Okay. And then we got a solo break. I think I got it. That's it. That's the whole song. AABA. 32 bars. Yeah, great. No problem. Yes, sir. No problem. Yeah, this is the process. So I got it on YouTube. I pulled up an example. Hank Mobley actually playing it. And I came up over the years hearing Joshua Redman play it first. That was my first introduction of it. And then I found out that, you know, Hank Mobley was the original. And then, yeah. So I got my reference here of Hank Mobley on YouTube, and then I pulled up jazz standards, learn jazz standards on another tab here. So now I can actually play the melody and solo a little bit. First of all, even before I go into the solo, I'm gonna outline the changes. Now I can hear the changes, but I want to give you just some insight on how you would do that. And here we go. I'm just kind of peeking at Facebook if you have any comments or questions, if I miss anything. Yeah, somebody, do you know what I love your sound? Seriously, say, do you know what I love your sound? Seriously, I appreciate you. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. All right, so now let's play the melody. So I got the melody down. I was just gonna go over here and try to turn this All right, cool. Now let's outline these changes. Let me start it back. Missed that one. So now I was just, you know, initially playing through the changes and kind of getting a feel for, you know, how it flows, how to flow through these changes. And so let me talk a little bit about what's going on. What up, Clay Pritchard? That's the man who need to do that. That's a bad boy. My man Clay is on watching. I really got to be on it now. Yes, sir. So, but anyway, what I would do is how I would look at this. I'm gonna play it without the play along, which is good. You need to practice these type of songs without the play alongs, just to help yourself better flow through these changes without leaning on the chords from the piano. Just trying to play continuous lines just to get used to connecting each chord together. And I'm just playing one, two, three. So continuous eighth notes. You know, eighth notes is one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And of course, when I would actually solo, I would build my solo and kind of think about telling a story, or think about being more melodic than being so technical and just flying through all the changes. But when I'm practicing, I'm just trying to get a feel for the changes. So that's why I'm playing continuous. All right. So. And so here's the thing, too. We have like certain lines that we kind of default to just because we're used to playing from certain points. And when I say certain points, I'm talking about playing from the root or playing a bebop scale when you're playing a seventh chord. And a bebop scale, just to show you, that's just playing the major seven and the flat seven within the scale descending. Say, I would need to improve my piano. Okay. I'm kind of looking at these messages as they come in. But, yeah, certain things I would just default to. What up? What up, Dre? My man Dre's in the house. All right. So, but, yeah, so what I would do is just, you know, certain licks that I would play, like over the seventh chords descending, you know, I have. You know, so we go. Then I go to the minor seven, minor 2-5. Then a 2-5-1 back to the E flat. You That's an enclosure. That's just enclosure stuff. Y'all know how I talk about it. In the for the people who are students in the academy, you have heard, and even the people who are used to my YouTube channel, I'm always talking about enclosures. So you got a combination of linear lines, which is like where you're moving scale-wise, or moving by intervals of seconds, you know, half steps and whole steps, you know, playing scales, scalar lines or scale-like lines. And then you got arpeggios, which is just, you know, stuff like that, every other note playing thirds. And then you have enclosures. You know, those are enclosures where you're surrounding a note. You're playing around the note that you, the chord tone, the one that you're going to land on beat one or beat three, just depending on it, on where we are. But you got those enclosures that you can play too. And so really, when you learn the jazz language, the bebop language or whatever, it's really a bunch of that, like arpeggios, linear lines, and enclosures. And so when you improvise on the fly, you just kind of learn to just put stuff in the right spots. And it's one of those things where we're executing these things within milliseconds. So sometimes as we're thinking about or hearing what we want to play, the beat might get off or get scoot, you know, a beat over, because the idea comes and we're in a certain place where we're trying to play it, but the changes are continuously moving. So we might carry over, you know, on another beat that we didn't intend, I won't say we didn't intend on, but because it's all about hearing it. And so what you do in improvising, you actually hearing stuff, but you also can't play what you haven't gone over. And if you do, you kind of make up or kind of improvise or kind of come up with how you can maneuver out of it. And that's the thing. We're maneuvering through changes. So, of course, there's certain things that I default to, but when I actually solo and I'm in a performance, I'm really trying to play something I haven't really played before. Sometimes I'll just, you know, just play what I hear and play what I feel. And then sometimes I'll just be like, I want to create something different. I want to try some different alterations. I want to try some different rhythms, or I want to just kind of see what feedback I'll get from the band if I do this, or let me see what the piano player is doing. And, you know, so it's so many variables that go into improvising to where, you know, that's why it's so fun, because you never know how a solo is going to be shaped. Because sometimes you gotta let go of everything and not be all in your head, because you're playing with a band. And so when we're playing with a band, that changes the spontaneous composition, because everybody has an input. You know, even though you might be up front as an instrumentalist, we are responsible for the melody and, of course, improvising and stuff like that. And but as we're playing with a drummer and playing with a bass player and the keyboard player, a piano player, like, they're influencing everything that we do. So it's kind of like you want to leave some space for them to participate in your solo, as so that they can help you better shape it. Now, when you're playing by yourself with play-alongs, of course, I mean, it's no interaction, so we can just work out stuff. But let me show you. I'm going to give you an example. I'm going to go ahead and play the melody, and I'm a solo and everything, and I'm going to try to put myself in a mindset where I'm going to play some different stuff. Thank you. You an opportunity to practice and try different things. So the challenge about playing double time is it's all about how you resolve, come out of the lines, the long lines you start. And so that's the thing. What's going on from Alabama? What's happening? So it's all about trying to figure out how you're gonna get out of what you started. Because you get to rambling and running around, and it's all about trying to connect everything together. And I think the tune really is too slow. It's a little slow. I would play it a little bit up. You know, that would feel better, because when I play fast, it's just, you know, I need it to be a little bit faster. All right, 60 times. Okay. I'm just looking at the chat here on YouTube. We say I listened to Mobley's Remember like 60 times. Yeah, he's so graceful and just tasteful with it. Appreciate it, Jay. All righty. So, yeah, but that's it, you know. I'm just kind of playing through the tune. I need to improve my plan. All righty. So, yeah, any questions? Other comments that you have? I have an issue with fingering the key. Oh, okay, finding the key of the song. I see what you're saying. So yeah, you got to work on singing, trying to sing and match as you, you know, listen. Just try to sing along with it. Cause I had to figure out the bass notes initially when I started learning songs, and you know, I would learn a bass line, learn a melody, learn the bass lines, or the bass notes, and then pick out the chords from what information you get. You know, you can piece it together from the top and bottom through learning the bass notes and the melody. What up, Clay? He said he enjoyed it. Great. I'm on Facebook just checking out some comments and stuff, but pretty much that's it. Say, want me to come over to Nigeria? I would love to. I'd love to come to Nigeria. All right, so that's pretty much it. Any questions? You know what's really harder? A challenge is playing by myself. I like it, though. So let's do it. Let's say.
Thank you.
See, I have better fun when I'm playing by myself because I got to keep everything going. But, yeah, that's it. That's Remember by Hank Mobley. So thank y'all so much for watching. I was able to get it in. I got some other calls that I got to catch, but you can definitely go back and rewatch this. And hit me up if you want me to do another one like this. Just shoot me a love offering. Let me know what you want me to cover. And yeah, my man gave me this idea and it was cool. Say, hey, won't you do a stream? And I'll send you, you know, something like a lesson. I was like, okay, cool. I'll do it. So here we go. Now everybody gets the benefit. So this is a cool idea. You know what? As a matter of fact, I would do that for another saxophone player. That's what y'all should do. For the cats who you really like and you want them to break down something, say, hey, I'll Cash App you this so that you can break down this song for me. I don't know. We'll come up with a name for it. But I definitely got somebody, some cats in mind who I would love to see a breakdown like this. But it's definitely a cool idea, and I think it'll be something that we can make a viral thing, really. So, yeah, so my information is here. If you like the lesson, I have all of my information, quamonfowler.com. You can get all of my products. I got some licks because I know some people have asked, hey, I want to get your licks. So if you go to Texas Tenor Music Academy, Texas Tenor Music Academy, TEXAS10ER, Music Academy, .com and click on catalog, and that's where I have my licks. I got a Q licks bundle, and I also have some play-alongs and different things for you there. If you wanted to get them, you can do that. Also, you can text me if you forget and want to find out. I have some questions about some of the stuff that I have. Just call me. My number is in the description of this video, and just shoot me a text and I'll reply back. My information is up on the screen. Y'all been looking at it since I've been up here. So if you want to support the channel, you can definitely do that by way of Zelle, PayPal, Cash App, and all of that Vimeo and all of that Venmo and all of that stuff. You know, we gotta do this now because the whole game is changed. They're not paying us nothing on the streams of our music. So we gotta do stuff like this to continue to keep the revenue coming in. But this actually kind of helps me transition into talking about even my entrepreneurial musician co-op. So I do have a co-op now. We meet every Monday, and this is where we talk about how we're creating different streams or multiple streams of income with music and beyond. So we got some trading going on, cryptocurrency trading and investing and some real estate and all of that. So these are a bunch of musicians, and some are not musicians, but they are into investing and different things. So if you're interested in that, go to emusician.info. That's emusician.info, and you can get all the information about that. And if you want to be a part of the co-op, just let me know. It is like donation-based, so if you want to donate, you have to have a crypto wallet. And if you don't know what that is, I'll definitely tell you about it and all of that. If you just shoot me an email at investingmusician.com, investingmusician@gmail.com. That's what I meant to say. But you can find out more if you shoot me an email and then just put co-op in there, and then I'll reply with information and we can hook up. So I think that's all my commercials, and that's all of what I have for you today. And yeah, let me know if you want me to do another one on a certain particular song, and I definitely will. I'll learn it and show you how I approach playing over it. All right. So somebody say jazz coin. Yeah, we need our own cryptocurrency. I'm going to look into that. All right. Yeah. Okay. All right. So let me look here. I'm just looking through some of the questions or comments to see if I missed something. I'm curious on how you approach tonguing when it comes to double time and phrases in faster tempos. Okay. I got you. All right, so double timing. Let me see if I got. Hey Siri, open metronome. What time is it? Because I got to run. I got some other stuff going on. I'm going to do this for you, though. What's going on? Do I have my Bluetooth on? Yep. Oh, no. 180. What you mean doing double time on 180? One, two, three. I think the only thing I can think about, if you do double time, that's what 360. It's really just kind of slurring. Yeah, that's really too fast. I gotta practice that. But really, I guess it's kind of like. It's a little doodle tonguing in there, but I have to do a whole nother lesson on how I would approach tonguing for doing double time. But you know, I ain't been playing like that to really nail it. I mean, it's cats out there who are in better shape, so you might catch somebody else like Clay or some other cats, Chad LB and them cats like that, you know. Maybe my man Walter. I checked him out on Instagram, Walter Smith. But anyway, I'm done, y'all. Much love to everybody, and we'll see you again next go around.